Thank you, Chairman Dutton. I just wanted to ask about Section 1 that indicates that this is, if a district receives funding from the Coronavirus Response and Relief Supplemental Appropriations Act, there doesn't seem to be any language there that brackets it to just to that 10%. There's concern that this can be applied to the entire amount that came from the federal government.
No, there's no way that could be possible.
I'm sorry, Mr. Speaker, I can't hear.
Members, please let your conversations outside the room.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I'm sorry, Chairman Dutton.
Yeah, there's no way that that could be possible, because what we've done is, I think last week or week before last, we've already sent $11.8 billion to the schools, and I think next week or shortly after that, they'll get the other $5.2 billion or somewhere thereabouts. And so they'll already have that money. So that money has already been gone to them.
Well, they're actually in the process, are they not, of doing the application process to get the funds. I don't know if they've actually received them yet.
No, they have received some funds, but they have not received all of them. But these funds are restricted to the 10% that's going to be dedicated to the commissioner out of the funds received.
And that's the 10% you're referring to is when the governor put out his press release with Speaker Phelan and Lieutenant Governor Patrick on April 28th, it indicated that 10% was going to be, the spending of that was going to be, the grants for the state were going to be determined by the Lieutenant Governor, the Speaker, Senators Nelson and Larry Taylor, Representatives Greg Bonin and Harold Dutton. So are y'all working on that now? Is that part of what this is about?
That's not part of this particular package, because what this does is the learning loss that the federal government has identified that occurred during COVID, that they put in terms of how we ought to use the money, that's what this goes to. This is not part of any other scheme or use of the money.
Okay, so I guess really what this gets down to for some of us is what's the need for this bill, since we already have this spelled out by the federal government in terms of how that 10% can be used?
Well, the federal government says how it can be used. What this does is tell how we use it. And so what we're going to do is set up tutoring programs to the extent that districts would like to apply for this money, for this grant, so that now the students who are behind can get caught up. It also specifies that the tutoring can only occur in, what we specified in the bill is the students will get 30 hours of tutoring, and they can only have a 1-to-3 ratio in terms of student teachers in the tutoring. It also specifies that in the tutoring of students, we won't use that as the basis for anything other than tutoring. For example, kids who are taking a particular class can't be pulled out of that class just to accommodate the tutoring. So what this does is provides an opportunity for those children, again, who are simply behind. And that is becoming a huge problem for us, because what we've found out is that students are behind. 6 years later, only 4% of those students get caught up. And that's because we haven't been doing the tutoring. Now, there is a provision in the statute that exists now that requires, well, it doesn't require, but it says school districts should do the tutoring. What this will do is for those school districts that believe they have huge problems with students' learning loss, they'll be able to now provide tutoring without any expense to them.
Well, Chairman Dutton, I appreciate what you just said, and I agree with you, and I appreciate the intention here. I still haven't understood from the answers, though, why this bill is necessary, since these things are already spelled out, and TPA could require those things for the grants anyway.
Well, it's necessary because we put the money in the budget. We put the $250 million in the budget. If we don't do this, then it just sits over there.
It sits over this, where?
It just sits over TEA to do
Why
nothing.
Why would it just sit there?
To do nothing.
Why would they not do anything with it?
Because there's no prescription from this legislature in what to do with it.
Why would they need the legislature to prescribe what to do with the federal funds? Since those were spelled out by the feds.
Those are the discretionary funds. Again, I go back to that. Those are the discretionary funds that allow the states to do what they want to do with the money in certain categories. But if you don't pick out one of those categories to put the money in, it never happens. And so that's what this does. This says...
I appreciate that. I don't understand what would prevent TEA from distributing this money, these grants, and why those decisions can't be made by them. I'm really still at a loss.
TEA, the school districts are in a better position to determine which of their students are failing and behind and need the help. What TEA is going to do is simply provide the money so that they can get that necessary help.
We're talking about people are sending me questions, but my question to you still remains unanswered in terms of why TEA can't do this without us passing this. The federal government has already listed how these things can be spent. Money is there. You're part of the committee.
Let me see if I can help you real quick.
Okay.
The TEA, we don't just send TEA a lump of money in the budget. You recognize that, right? We don't just say we're going to send TEA $200 or $700 billion for the school program.
Members, please take your conversations outside the chamber.
I'm trying to hear.
Yeah. So we don't just send them a bunch of money, but this legislature tells them how to spend the money. And what this does is, in keeping with that same spirit, we're simply telling TEA to use $230 million or so on providing grants to districts who want to participate in it for tutoring for those children who are behind.
Because we don't trust that the commissioner would do this anyway?
No, because he doesn't have any authority to do it unless we tell him.
Okay, that still doesn't make sense to me, but thank you anyway.
All right, okay. Mr. Speaker, I move passage.